In a controlled process, only random influences, i.e. common causes, occur. These random influences lead to normally distributed data of the output if the data were measured on a cardinal scale. The distribution of data of cycle types can be steep on the left and skew on the right. This is because the cycle times cannot fall below a lower limit, but can take any value upwards. Except for the skewness, however, the cycle times can be free of any systematic influences, i.e. special causes. Specific influences on the process, on the other hand, lead to signals in the output data. They are reflected in extreme single values or patterns of adjacent values. Control charts are used to map the output values chronologically in relation to the mean value and the control limits in a time series plot, and to map the variation of adjacent values or in subgroups. For our sample size from the first week after the improvement with n smaller or equal 100, I recommend the IMR control chart, which can resolve all single values graphically. The individual value chart shows the cause of all values, a horizontal line for the mean, as well as for the upper and lower control limit. In the X-bar-S and X-bar-R chart, the sample is divided into subgroups, and each data point in the chart represents the mean value of a subgroup. In the moving range chart, the differences of adjacent values are mapped. Here the data points indicate the variation between values. The first data point corresponds to the difference of the second and the first value. The second data point refers to the difference of the third and the second value, and so on. In the X-bar-S chart, the variation is indicated by data points with the standard deviation in the subgroups. And in the X-bar-R chart, each data point represents the range in the respective subgroup. Our data of the first week show extreme values and patterns, conspicuous deviations from a random scattering, and therefore cannot be distributed normally. Statistically, it is possible that such extreme values and patterns happen by chance, but the probability for this is extremely low. We therefore rather assume underlying special causes. In addition to graphically displaying the values and limits, specific tests of the control charts can identify extreme values and patterns in the data. Minitab offers two variants of the mentioned control charts, via the Assistant and via Statistics menu, which differ in the extent of these tests on signals. The IMR chart from the Assistant displays two test results for the cause of the individual values. Test 1, one value outside the control limits. This is the overlooked invalid value outside the range of the rating scale. Test 2, a shift of the mean from the 10th to the 14th value. After a very bad start, the taste of the cookies improved continuously in this period of the first week. In this ramp-up phase, our measures became more and more effective. The tests of the IMR control chart from the Minitab Statistics menu index further patterns. Test 2 indicates a suspicious number of values in a row on the same side of the center line. This indicates that we started with a series of bad-tasting cookies. As a cause, we assume that our chef did not work according to the new standard at the beginning of the week and continued to nibble on chocolate. Test 4 indicates that there are several points in a row alternating up and down. This ping-pong can point to sequential dependencies, where a bad result causes a good one, and vice versa. This may be the case, for example, when the response of a process to an intervention is delayed and we enter a phase of alternating over and understeering. But it is also possible that our chef was supervised on every second order, applying the new standard and then returning unobserved to her previous habits. For the moving range chart, the test 1 also indicates an extreme value in both control charts. Here the large difference between the invalid value and the subsequent valid value is displayed as an outlier. Test 2 points on 18 and 12 points in a row on the same side of the center line. This means that in the first period, the difference between all adjacent values was relatively small, and that the differences between adjacent values in the second period was relatively big. The causes for this are the continuous bad cookies in the first period and the ping-pong with big differences between adjacent values in the second period. To bring the process under control, each systematic event should be analyzed and its root causes should be eliminated. This strategy may become cumbersome, but the result can be a controlled excellent process with only common causes leading to only random variations. And this procedure already describes the future monitoring of the process for extreme values and patterns. For the calculation of the process capability now, the ramp-up data of the first week will be excluded. This section also repeats the corresponding evaluation from the analysis phase, only with new data, and thus allows a before-after comparison. I select the before-after capability analysis of the Minitab Assistant. The specified target as well as the specification limits are of course the same for this comparison. The statistical parameters show improvements in the mean and standard deviations. In relation to the target and specification limits, this also leads to an improvement in the capability indices, PPK and Z-bench, our sigma level, which increased from 1.93 to 4.90. The corresponding percentage outside the specification dropped from 2.66 to 0, i.e. a difference of 2.66, which is indicated as a 100% reduction. This evaluation of the Minitab Assistant additionally displays statistical tests of the position and dispersion of the process. The change in dispersion is tested by the two-sample standard deviation test, i.e. the F-test. The chart for the F-test indicates that the standard deviation of the ratings is significantly reduced in the new sample. And the next diagram also shows, based on the two-sample t-test, that the mean value of the ratings has improved significantly, from 2.46 to 1.65. And this improvement is also practically relevant, as we think. We now offer our customers a better and more consistent taste experience. The histograms for the before-after comparison with the overlaid target and the upper specification limit demonstrates these changes. The related Anderson-Darling normality test indicates a significant deviation from the normal distribution. Thus again, the results must be interpreted under reserve. But we can see that we clearly improved our chocolate cookies. The ratings of taste increased in the sample 0.81 rating points on a 6-level rating scale. And regarding customer requirements, we have improved the taste of the chocolate cookies by about 3 sigma levels. Although it makes sense that the Minitab Assistant for process capability already contains statistical tests, this is not the case in every statistics program. Therefore, I will now formulate the appropriate hypothesis and calculate these tests again separately.